Hey guys, so of course it's video time and I'm really excited because I like to talk about more than what you might see out there in the keto stratosphere. I want to go down that rabbit hole and look under the hood and the trunk of the car to really find out what's going on, boom, with your body. And it's pretty dark, but yes, I have energy, and I like to, a lot of newbies chime in. So I'm doing things to let people know why it is that I push keto so much. So this is the business, but it is so dark in here. And I think I need to shut the blinds to get a better perspective. You guys can see me more. I also just be seeing my teeth. That does the trick. Okay, so that helps a little bit more. All right, guys. So what's the deal? I want to talk to you guys about, like, what's going on on the inside of the old body, right? A lot of you guys find keto because you're obsessed on what the body looks like. But I'm obsessed with what the body looks like on the inside to the outside. Yes, that's what I'm really, really excited about. So this is the unsexy part of ketogenesis. But you know what? If you don't know what I'm about to tell you, you ain't gonna keto adapt and you're not gonna have the business. You're not going to have the body that you so desire, or the energy, or the energy levels. So let's get on to some of the kind of the details of what's going on the inside. So basically, a lot of you guys don't realize that you're not methylating. I've mentioned these types of things before. You're not methylating, you're not detoxing, your highways are blocked up, you have inflammation. You're not creating ketones, you're not going through fatty acid metabolism, you don't use glucose well. That's all these things, right? Your fuzzy brain, you've got inflammation, weird little, you know, wounds or gout or, you know, nails cracking or lines in them and spots and discoloration and, you know, circles under the darkness and pigmentation issues, like hyperpigmentation issues, eczema, you name it. And it's happening to all of us. Women with their menstrual cycle issues, yo, every consultation, oh, there goes another one bites the dust, like, immediately. Menstrual issues, and we know that men have issues with their DHT, but men don't often check those numbers to see where the testosterone is or their estradiol. They don't test their reproductive hormones or their DHT numbers, so they don't even know, a lot of them, until they're just so, they have like huge erectile dysfunction. Yeah, I said it. And that's when men start to become curious and actually go to a doctor. Because, of course, we know that women more go to their doctors than men do. But I understand. I mean, the medical industry is convoluted with pharmaceuticals. So I understand the fear to go. But at least we can check sort of numbers to kind of find out where you're sort of at. But let's go more into it. So lately, I've been really excited to kind of push people, because people constantly talk about blood values. They send me their blood results. Please do not do that anymore, because I'm not qualified to go over your blood results, but I digress. So basically, we want to go into a little bit of what? A great solution to find out what the hell is going on, why you're depressed, why you've got ADD, you got mood disorder and schizophrenia and, you know, all of these types of issues, as I call them, is to maybe do a little bit of organic acid testing, or maybe go and do an MTHFR gene mutation test, right? To find out what's going on with your SAMe, or if you have enough glutathione production within the body, was like the super antioxidant. These are the, like, deep down inside the rabbit's hole that we have to start looking at on trying to understand why we're tired and our bodies won't respond to what we want it to do. Yes. So it's really simple. You can go online and order this test. It's stool, saliva, and urine. Hello. Okay, so many, like, think about the next things I'm going to say. I'm like, can't get it all in the brain. So you want to test your stool, your urine, and your saliva to see what you're losing. A lot of people have, I realize, they say, look at your pee to see if it's bubbly, to see if you have protein loss. also, I explain to people to, you know, do stool testing to see, to find out if they have a parasite or if they have candida. And, like, I need to do a strict candida video because people don't understand how candida, dangerous it can be if you have an overgrowth of it for long periods of time. And people have such a hard time to get rid of their candida. Some people's guts are so freaking, they're, like, abolished that they actually have to do a transplantation of fecal matter from a baby, healthy baby, that has all the right gut flora, because once you lose it through antibiotics and sugars and stress, you don't just get it back because you eat some probiotic foods. It doesn't work like that. We also want to check to see with what's going on with your urine for the loss. You're losing things within the urine. You want to see if your body is how the ketone production is going, not just in, well, that's also blood with using your glucometer, but you want to see if your ketones are being wasted. So I like thinking about the urine in the context of, are you getting your B's in? Are you getting your B complex? Are you getting your vitamin D in? Do you have enough vitamin D? People don't understand that, you know, the methylation process to be able to detox your body, you might even have a gene mutation, but if you can get your body in order, like get rid of all the toxic things in your environment as best as you can, and then sleep and then learn how to exercise correctly while doing a ketogenic protocol is a way of learning how to methylate with a gene mutation. I know, because we want to boost our glutathione production. That's our internal antioxidant. And it's like the number one, like it just makes like green tea look like So that's why it's super important. And a lot of things, like people have B12 deficiencies. And like I said, B12 deficiencies lead to methylation deficiencies. And this is a problem because you have a methylation issue. You're turning on crappy genes and you're turning off good genes. And that's what makes you age. And we don't want that. So if you look, if you go down that rabbit's hole and you really try to find out why you have depression, right? Because when you're doing organic acid testing, you can find out what's going on with your serotonin, your dopamine, the neurotransmitters. It's like, it's so important to understand what you're losing through the urine, what hormones are not being produced. If you're losing amino acids, if you're losing your branched chain amino acids, all of these things can take that high-performance Maserati and slow it down and make it drive like a Yugo. Yes, or Gremlin. Remember those old cars? So this is what we have to consider. A lot of people find keto because they're obsessed with losing weight. All this crap on the internet. And I'm not angry. No, I'm very happy. But I'm very passionate, right? All this crap that you see and everybody else, everybody's a keto expert talking about, you know, you can eat this protein or this nuts or who cares, right? Let's go down the rabbit's hole and find out how much metabolic damage you have, because that is no BS. That's non-BS reality, right? You can go ahead and lose 60 pounds on the scale and be like, I did keto and I lost tons of weight and I'm in ketosis. No, you're not. Are you methylating? Do you have a gene mutation, right? What's going on with your Sammy or your glutathione? Oh! You don't know. Y'all call me crazy for jumping around in videos and showing off the business, right? I'm 48. This is 48. This is the reason why I show my body. Because I'm around a lot of people in my age demographic who never believe that they can get there again, that they can find their youth. This isn't about being slim or being muscular. This is about being healthy, right? To not age prematurely, to not lose your menstrual cycle and be in a state of peri too early. Being thin is not indicative of being healthy at all. At all. 5'3", weigh 128. Girl is not thin. No. I'm lean. Yeah, I'm lean. You see abs, but this is not being thin, right? Steph has built this body solid as a rock. At the age of 48, where I'm supposed to be entering peri, and I have women say, Stephanie, what's going on with your menstrual cycle? Because mine's getting a little weird, and I'm 44, and I'm like, 28 days, 5 to 6 days on point feet correct, because I'll do everything in my power to balance my reproductive hormones rather than focusing on if I can fit into my skinny jeans or not, because I don't give a crap. I don't give donkey balls about it. And if you guys think I'm too old to say donkey balls, I'm just saying. That's what I want to talk about, you guys. Organic acid testing is awesome. It's like new ways to go down that rabbit hole to find out what's going on with your body so you guys can have energy, so you can repair your skin cells, right? So you can fix the telomeres on your DNA chain. That's what it's about. And if you can get your body healthy and you're able to fix your systems one by one, and then your lean body mass and your hormones balance, and you start to feel that your muscles become tight, if that's the affectation, then so be it. Then that's what I promote. Yes, 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 absolutely. So go down the rabbit's hole. Find out about your glucose metabolism. You guys aren't your glucose makers. You're not getting into ketosis is not easy. Being highly keto adapted, if I have a dollar for every time somebody said, I'm in ketosis, and they do these before and after pictures, and you see all of this this dumping of muscle, this stress, the catabolism on the body, weight is not indicative of weight loss. That's not indicative of being healthy, because you can still have a lot of visceral fat around your organs and still be skinny fat. So let's not get it twisted. Steph doesn't give weight loss advice. Steph gives fat loss advice, especially that visceral fat, by talking about things like glutathione and methylating. Yeah, 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 yeah. What's up? Yes. Freaking hungry. I am so thirsty to learn more about the body. I've gone through so many consultations now with people, and it all starts to make sense. I get my information from you guys, because ketogenesis hasn't been, the published studies haven't gone over 30 days. So in that first 30 days, you're going through the keto flu. So when people are trying to learn what is the difference between dropping weight and being in ketosis, understanding the macros, and why I say animal fat is so important for the fatty acid profile of mono, SFAs, and polys, the perfect ratios of those fatty acids, that's what's important to understand in creating ketones that can be used as a viable source of energy or beta-hydroxybutyrate for the brain, right? So 6 years and gaining 15 pounds on keto and keeping a lean body mass and being almost 50 and not having your skin and dry out and your body fall apart, you have to go down the rabbit's hole and open up the hood of the car and find out where this all started. Probably the first thing that where it started is right here in your personality, because you were allowing yourself to stay up too late. You were allowing yourself to drink alcohol and drink caffeine and eat poor quality foods. This is where you lose the ability to methylate properly, and genes turn off and genes turn on. Things like the reason why a lot of people can heal from their MS is because certain bad genes are turned on. And if you learn the ability to turn off bad genes and turn on good genes, that's how you deal with disease. All right, guys, if you want to learn more how to get into ketosis and get healthy and get lean as far as getting rid of your visceral fat and just enough of the subcutaneous fat to be healthy, then you can go to stephanieperson.com, Stephanie the Business Person on my Facebook fan page, or Stephanie Ketogenic on my Instagram, and I am just getting started. By the way, you guys, I started a new Periscope. I started with the name Stephanie Ketogenic, but I'm connecting it to my Twitter. So you would go to Stephanie the Biz, which is THEBIZ, and that's my Periscope name and my Twitter name. So if you search up Stephanie, you'll see two Periscope names. One is Stephanie Ketogenic, but I'm switching it over to my Twitter account, which is Steph the Biz. I think that's it. Steph the Biz. The Biz. Yeah, the Biz, because this is the business and diffuse lighting. So let's learn more. Let's get this conversation and follow me on Periscope. It's my new kind of thing, because I can interact with you guys And that is what's really exciting, because you guys come at me with a lot of questions and everybody gets to see, hear what the answer is. So, peace out!